Welcome to the MOOC course on Abnormal Psychology. This course is open to undergraduate students. What are you going to learn in this course? This course covers the basics of abnormal psychology. What is abnormal psychology? What is the classification of various disorders which are categorized according to standard systems of classification? And what are the details of these disorders? What are the causes? What is the clinical picture? What are the therapies which are used? All these will be comprehensively covered under this course. To give you an overview of what all contents are there in this course, the first unit will start with the introduction as well as classification of abnormal behavior. It takes you into a historical perspective of abnormal psychology. And then from there on, we move on to the classification of psychological disorders. We are going to talk about two systems of classification, standard systems of classification, that about DSM-5, which is the latest classification, as well as ICD-10. In addition to this, we are also going to talk about the theoretical perspectives to psychological disorders. They may be biological perspectives, behavioral perspectives, cognitive perspectives, humanistic perspectives, psychoanalytic to start with, and so on. Let me tell you, while I talk about this classification system, we are going to introduce to you the latest classification system of American Psychiatric Association, that is called DSM-5. You will know the details when you go into the lesson. While we introduce this lesson to you, please also note that the disorders which are going to be discussed in detail will be in tune with the previous classification system, that is DSM-4-TR. Mainly the reason is many textbooks yet cover, as of now, the system of classification which is DSM-4-TR. However, the system of classification, that is DSM-5, the changes included in it and what all have been additionally added or deleted or modified are discussed in detail in the first unit itself. So, now from here we move on to the second unit, which talks about the causal factors of these psychological disorders that I was mentioning about. For example, we are going to talk about the biological factors, the psychological factors, socio-cultural factors, all these are going to be discussed. From here, we move on to different anxiety disorders. We talk about the nature of the anxiety disorders and we talk about the types of anxiety disorders. We talk about the generalized anxiety disorder, we talk about panic, anxiety in particular, and then obsessive compulsive disorder, the phobias, and then post-traumatic stress disorder. All these disorders are going to be discussed. From here, we move on in the next unit to dissociative and somatoform disorders. Once again, we talk about the nature of dissociative disorders and the types of dissociative disorders, like we talk about dissociative amnesia, dissociative fugue, and dissociative identity disorder. And then we also talk about the somatoform disorders. Moving on from dissociative disorders, we talk about hypochondriasis, we talk about somatization disorder. Then we talk about somatoform disorders like pain disorder, conversion disorder, and then Munchausen syndrome by proxy, and then body dysmorphic disorder. These are all the various disorders that we are going to discuss. From these disorders, we move on to psychotic disorders. Once again, we talk about schizophrenia, we talk about mood disorders, unipolar disorders, bipolar disorders. From there, we move on to psychophysiological disorders. We talk about cardiovascular disorders, the coronary heart disease. We talk about hypertension. We talk about cancer, chronic fatigue syndrome, headaches and different types of headaches, tension headache, migraine headache, cluster headache. And then we talk about irritable bowel syndrome. These are some of the psychophysiological disorders that we are going to talk about. From here, we move on to the important aspect of a human's life, that is the childhood, the disorders which are related to childhood. Attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, tic disorder, Tourette's disorder, oppositional defiant disorder, conduct disorder. These are some of the disorders that we are going to discuss. Then we go to pervasive developmental disorders, autistic disorder, Asperger's disorder, childhood disintegrative disorder are some of the disorders that we are going to talk about. Then we move on to intellectual disability, the historical views, the causes, the levels of intellectual disability, prevention. What are the types of prevention and what are the interventions? We cover all these aspects of intellectual disability. Then we move on to eating disorders like binge eating and other eating disorders like anorexia nervosa, bulimia nervosa. We finally move to personality disorders. There are three categories under this, cluster A, B, C. So we talk about all these three clusters, odd and eccentric behavior, and under that the several personality disorders which are categorized, then dramatic, emotional or erratic behavior, under which again several personality disorders which are discussed under this. Under each of these clusters, what all categories of disorders are discussed are explained in detail in these lessons. From here, we move on to cognitive impairment disorders, delirium, Parkinson's disease, dementia, Alzheimer's disease, Pick's disease, Huntington's disease. Then we move on to the brain trauma, brain injuries, strokes, tumors, infections. Then also we talk about amnestic disorders, cerebrovascular disorders, vascular dementia and Korsakoff syndrome. Then Wernicke's encephalopathy, epilepsy, all these are also discussed. Addiction and impulse control disorders is one more important area that we are going to discuss next. The nature and types of addiction are discussed, substance use disorders, substance dependence, substance abuse, substance induced disorders, these are also going to be discussed. Then alcohol related disorders and the treatment is also discussed, drug abuse and treatment is discussed. Then comes the impulse control disorders like kleptomania, pyromania, compulsive gambling are discussed. Then finally, the last chapter talks about the treatment of psychological disorders. We talk about major therapies in this. The major tenets of major psychotherapies are discussed. Then we talk about psychodynamic therapy in detail, humanistic therapy in detail, behavior therapy, cognitive therapy, cognitive behavior therapy. Brief therapies are also discussed, and integrative approach to treatment and group approaches are also discussed as a part of this. Thus, abnormal psychology syllabus takes you into a journey of several disorders related to human behavior. And not only about the clinical features of these disorders, but also the etiology, the causal picture, as well as possible therapies are also discussed in detail.